calculator. So how do you do this from financial calculator? So this is your financial calculator, how it this is how it looks like. This specific line is, this specific line of buttons or row of buttons is for time value of money. And even in Excel, for those who have been who have been into financial modeling or who have used Excel at work or in studies, would know that this same time value of money, variables are also used in Excel. So in Excel, again, you have a formula known as equals to PV, equals to FV, equals to PMT, equals to rate. So you have these same variables being used in Excel as well. Those same variables are used by financial calculator as well. So it works exactly the same way as Excel works. So you have a series of buttons for time value of money. This N is number of periods. IY is interest rate slash yield, which is your interest rate or discount rate. PV is present value. PMT is payment, which we will use later. FV is future value. So if you are told that present value is $100, and if you are told that number of time period is, for example, 1 year, and if you are told that for example interest rate is 10%, and you have to calculate future value, how do you actually calculate future value? You input these three numbers into your calculator and compute future value. How do you do this? So in your financial calculator, first thing is press CE/C so that you clear the screen. Once you have cleared the screen, then clear any numbers which are stored within this within these values or against these variables. And how do you do this? You use shift and clear work. What is clear work? So if you look into the into these buttons, there is some text written on the button and there is some text written in yellow on the top of the button. So this yellow function is performed by first pressing the second button and then pressing the this button. So if I press second and then CE, it will perform this CLR work function. If I press second and then 7, it will perform this data function. If I press second and then 4, it will perform this function. So this is how it is performed. So this CLR work means clear work. It will clear your memory from time value of money. So if you do second and CE/C, it will clear time value of money variable. So it will store 0 in all of these values. If you had stored anything earlier, that would get removed. So second and clear work. Now you move on and you start entering values. So remember how you enter in financial calculator is first press the number, that is do 100, and when you see 100 on screen, then you press N. And when you press N, this 100 gets stored into N. So remember, you do not need to press N first and then the number. If you do that, then it will go wrong. First press when put the number on the screen, and then press N and it will get stored into N. Now do not press N again when you see any other number on the screen. Just press clear work and come back to the screen. Now IY is your interest rate. So press 10 or put 10 on your screen. Make sure you put it in percentage terms. Do not put it in decimal. Your calculator would know that you are inputting it in percentage. So press 10 and then press I/Y. When you do this, this 10 gets stored into IY. Then again clear CE, and then when you then you have to input present value. Now recall from your Excel working, when in Excel you are putting in a present value, you put it as negative to get a positive future value, and when you are calculating present value, you put future value as negative when you have to get a present value. Why? Because it works as per loan amortization schedule. It assumes that this present value is an outflow and what you are receiving in future is an inflow. So that's why if you are putting in present value as positive, it will give you a negative FV. If you put it in as negative, it will give you a positive FV. So put present value as -100, not 100. And how do you put in -100? Again, do not just do minus and 100, but instead put 100, write 100 on your screen. And once you see 100, press this plus minus button. When you press it, it will change it to minus 100. Otherwise, if you do minus 100, then it will subtract 100 from whatever number was there on the screen. So press 100, put 100, and then press plus minus button, and it will change it to minus 100. Once you see minus 100 on the screen, press PV, and it gets stored into present value. Payment, we are not into NVT, we have not discussed NVT payments as yet, so this is 0. So press 0, press PMT, it will store 0 in PMT. Then moving on, future value, it is something that you have to calculate. So how do you calculate? Press this compute button, press FV, and it will give you the future value. So one second. N is 1 year and PV is minus 100, IY is 10, payment is 0. And when you compute your future value, it should come out as 110. So compute future value, it will come out as 110. Any problem so far? Similarly, if you have to calculate present value, you put in all other numbers and compute PV. If you have to calculate rate, you put in all other numbers and compute rate. So these are four variables. From these four variables, if you have three with you, you can find out four easily using your calculator. Another thing to note about calculator is that once you have put in the numbers, if now you want to check that what is there in N, how do you check it? You cannot just press N, because if you press N, whatever is there on a screen will get saved into N. So how do you use it, find out what is stored in these numbers? You find that out using a button known as recall button. So this RCL means recall. So you press RCL, you press N, and it will show you whatever is stored in N. You press RCL again, press IY, it will show you whatever is stored in IY. So you can use this button to see what is actually stored in this, all these variables. Again, if you want to, for clearing TVM, you need to clear TVM, CLR TVM. So you press second and press this CVM, and it will clear CVM, and it will clear all the numbers there. Now if you recall N, it will show as 0. If you recall IY, it will show as 0. Everything will be shown as 0 because you have cleared everything from there. So this clear TVM will clear out the TVM numbers. This will be used for data register, which we will do later.